Hi friends, in this video we will see some of the built-in symbols that are available already in the data type such as object, arrays and other things. Up to now we have seen how to create our own symbol and using that one in our objects or arrays we have seen. But objects itself has some built-in symbols. So these symbols will be used for that for some of the methods and all those things. So we can also override these symbols. So with these built-in symbols we can also override. So these symbols are called as well-known symbols, and these symbols will be accessed using the static properties. So let's see some of the examples how we can override the functionalities of these symbols. Let's see, I have a class here, person. Okay, if I create an object for this person, if I check the console.log person, and if I try to run this one, I am getting as object and object. So here, you will be able to see here, we are getting the output as object, but here we have created an object of a person. So it will be better if it displays object person instead of displaying it as object object. So for example, if I convert it into two string, okay, if I check the output, I am getting it as object object only. So we can override the default, we can override this functionality to override the default description of the object. So how we can override that one? So we have a static property available, symbol dot to string tag. So we can use this static property and we can override the object description. So whenever the user uses that person dot to string, we can override that one. So here if I want to override person dot prototype of symbol dot to string tag, okay, to string tag you can use. And you can override your own functionality like this. And if I want to check the output, I can check the output here, object person. And also now we can see these all type of static properties if you type in the Google symbols. Okay, if you type in the Google symbols JavaScript, here you will be able to see all the static properties that are available for an object or anything. So here if you go here, static, these are the static properties. So here if you see, iterator. So whenever we are using for off loop for the object, so this method symbol.iterator will be executed so that you can override the for behavior for the object. So these are all the strings you can use. So we have used two string tag, right? So now I will show you another example, two primitive. So how we can use this one? For example, I have let numbers is equal to 1, 2, 3. Okay, so I will try to print the numbers. If I try to print the numbers, let's assume what would be the output. I am getting 1, 2, 3. So if I 2 plus 1, so what could be the behavior? So numbers are converting into the strings and one is appending to this one. So now we can change the behavior of this primitive type. Okay, so now how we can change this one is, so numbers of symbol dot to primitive. Okay, so this one we will be having, so in this one you will be having one of the index of this one known as symbol.proveToPrimitive. So it will execute a function, okay, and we can return whatever the thing you want, you can return here. Okay, so it will return 99. So now if I try to execute the output, what could be the output here? Here I am getting 100. Why? Because numbers is returning for me 99 and here it is returning +100. So if I try to print numbers here, so what could be the output? I'm getting 1, 2, 3 only. But if I am trying to add anything to this one, so this one will convert into 99 and this one will print 100 here. If I check here, so I am displaying the 100. So you can change any default, what we can say, any arithmetic operations you are applying for this one, you can change this one to the primitive thing so that you can apply, you can add the or the subtract, these are the arithmetic operations you can do. So this is, these are the already present symbol, symbol static, well-known symbols present in the object or arrays. So here we have used to primitive. So in the same thing, symbol dot to split. So if you are using any split operation, split method for this one, you want to change the behavior of the split, you can change using symbol dot split. So in the same scenario, symbol dot replace match iterator. Iterator is nothing but when you are using for loop, if you want to change the behavior of that object. So when you are looping over the array or of object, so if you want to do the custom logic, so you can use this one. So these are the static properties or the well-known symbols present in the ES6. So if you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comment below to this video. And if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.